Hi, I'm Chris Edwards with Tennis Warehouse, and I'm here today to give you a first look at the all-new Adidas Ubersonic 4. Now, if you're a big fan of the Ubersonic 2, you're really gonna dig this shoe. I've been playing in this shoe for a little over a month now, and I love the low to the ground, fast and supportive ride. It's given me, really reminds me of the 2, but I feel like the cushioning is better in this one. This one features Adidas's light strike cushioning system through the midsole here, and I've got it in this top secret early release colorway. So it's camouflage and hard for you to see some of the features on the shoe, but the cushioning system, it's really responsive. It's very light feeling under my feet. It protects me really well. I've played exclusively on hard courts in this shoe, and my feet have been super well protected by the cushioned ride of this one. And yet it also feels low to the ground. I feel very secure in my movement. I can sprint side to side. I don't feel like I'm rolling over or the shoe's compressing too much there. And then also, I just feel really connected to my movement too. So I have a good sense of how I'm moving on the court, and that's really helped me sprint around very effectively. Up at the top of the shoe here, we've got a prime knit booty construction. So fully enclosed, the tongue is part of the ankle collar. Very comfortable, excellent padding inside the shoe. I have a skinny foot, so no problems here for me to just slide my foot in, but there's a ring at the back of the shoe, which is gonna help you get your foot in there. And you can kind of pry it open a bit and open it up if you have a wider foot, should I say. Now let's have a look at some of the other features on the upper. Got nice breathability through the tongue of the shoe. And there's a lot of mesh on the surface here that you look at, but underneath, it's loaded with support elements to really wrap the foot and hold you. So when you're making those aggressive lateral cuts and quick stops, your foot stays solid. It doesn't balloon out over the midsole. It's really locked in. Attaches to the lace system too. So when you cinch it up, you really feel, get a sense of the upper cinching around your foot. Up at the toe of the shoe, and you can see I've done quite a bit of damage up here to the toe of these ones. Got a nice toe bumper on it. For a lightweight, speed-oriented shoe, I've been really impressed with the toe durability. I do obviously drag my toes quite a lot, as you can see right there, but it's holding up nicely. As I said, I got about a month of play testing on this one, so holding up super well right there. Let's have a look at the outsole now. We've got a modified herringbone tread pattern here, which extends the length of this unit, one piece unit. You can also see a little bit of the shank coming through there. I found the traction to be really solid on this one. I wouldn't say it's so sticky that you get hung up on the small movements. I felt like I could pivot in it nicely. But then also when I was coming to a quick stop, I could also, there was enough give to give me a little bit of slide out of a stop, kind of take some of the pressure off the knees and ankles. So I thought it hit the mark on that one. I give this one actually, if we're rating out of 5, I get a 5 out of 5 stars for traction because I thought it offered perfect blend of grip and give. So as you can tell, I've been really enjoying my time in these Ubersonic 4s. Can't wait for you guys to get a pair on your feet, and be sure to comment and let us know what you think.